It's on, yep, it's recording. So this is my current setup. It's a power tech, it's a one-off silencer. I'll try and get the story right. It was the boy who worked for Carbon. I don't know how it worked. I think he went out on his own. He either worked for Carbon Can Company or I don't know, but it's something like that. It's the thing with these dusters. As soon as you hit the rubber, they just leave bits. This is my current silencer. I'll just start it up, let you listen to it. So I'll tilt this camera back. So that's the current setup, little Bandit, but I've got something in the post today. I'm just going to speak about it. So this came in the post today. It's I'll show you what it is. You'll probably guess what it is. I had a Nectar voucher, and I already had a little tiny wee bit in the PayPal account, so I thought, well, all told, it wasn't an awful lot of money to spend out. Put this light on, this is great with this light on. Might be a bit too bright there. I'll try it. It's basically, there's quite a weight in it. All this stuff in there, yep, it's a little silencer. Let me get something to put on here, get rid of that standing lid. There's a little cloth there. Use my painting cloth just to keep it. It's a brand new thing. I want to keep it nice. It's a little I kind of like the style of the cut of the, actually feels not too bad. Hopefully this camera's picking this up. It's the first time I've tried this. All I've done is stuck the mount to the wall. So the camera's kind of going like that. I'll turn this light off actually. See if this one's any better up here. That might be better. But it's nice. Yeah, it's better than I thought it was going to be. And you got a DB killer in there. Let's just take that DB killer out. I want to have a look at that. Get rid of this box. Anything else in there? Oh, I'm actually quite impressed by the weight of it. I'll give it a good clean before my hands are kind of oily. I'll give it a clean with some, I'll find what I need, some Indoline. But actually, it's Chinese, okay? You've got a little bit there for, what's that? How does that come out then? I need a tool to get that out. That reduces it down. But all I need is the 51mm. It cost me £18 because I had the Nectar voucher and I had a little bit of money in the PayPal. So the baffle looks pretty severe. That'll restrict it, especially a big Bandit. But it feels really nice. I was so surprised. I thought it'd be a little junk. Just for £18, I thought I'd give it a go, you know. Let's get this baffle out. because it's new, I want to keep it kind of nice, you know. Feel better doing it upside down so that the bolt falls with gravity. There we go. Buffer that. There we go. It's got two connections for the baffle. What is that then? Ah, see, you can take that. There's a little cap there you can take out. Let's take that out. There's another one. Possibly too small. I can do it all three ways, but I think that will really restrict my Bandit. You can see there's a bit on the end there. You know, for it was 33 pound and 18p, and I paid about 18 quid because of my vouchers, and I'm very impressed. But before I start it up, I'm going to give it a good clean rundling. So that goes in there, this will make it straight through, but it will reduce the noise of it. I'll leave that out for now. Actually, I'll put it in, I'm going to put it in and I'll see the difference. So put the baffle in, put a bit of grease on that, and a little washer as well, a spring washer. There's my spring washer department. Spring washers are there. I've got little black ones. I haven't got any stainless, but a little black one will be fine. So painted. Look at this. Carbon steel. What size do I need? That's too big, is it? Not spot on. Spot on. It's just getting it in now. Fiddly. Do it upside down, right? That's it. That's it. Tighten it up. I just wanted something a bit. I love the style of these exhausts, so I want something a bit different. And I'm looking up the rest of the kit as well. That's it, kind of tight. I thought it was a bit of grease in it, didn't it? It's coming out anyway. But I do like the baffles in my bikes, I don't like them. Look at that, I'm very impressed. This will have to come out because this is going to restrict it. That just pulls out fantastic. And these are going to have to come off, these little tabs, because they'll get in the way. I think they'll get in the way of the strap. What do we get in here? You know me, always careful with the bags. Always cut them open, not rip them open. Plus, it's another little bag, storage. Yeah, here we go. Pour that out, get rid of this in a minute. So it's a Chinese, obviously it's Chinese because it's a Chinese email. But it was a UK, so you've got these little things, obviously these have to be welded onto, stainless welded onto the, I could get somebody to do that. If anybody's got a welder with just stainless rods or stainless wire, you quickly tap them on and you get the little springs. How do you do that? It might make it look a bit smarter. And you get this for the strap, a brand new bolt for this strap. Fantastic. You get a little stainless strap with the rubber. Put that on just now. Possibly get a little bit of oil just to help it, but it feels kind of quite pliable. So next time you see me, I'll have this installed on the bike. But first thoughts are nice, really nice. I'm not going to cut these off and leave them, give me options. I'll just put the clamp on about there. But I'll keep these little tabs on, just in case I need to send it back as well. But it's exceeded my expectations. I haven't got it on the bike yet. I don't know what it sounds like. I don't know what the bike performs like. But build quality, I am very impressed. I'm so surprised, you know. It seems a bit cheeky me saying that, but do you know what I mean? And they say it's stainless, so it won't rust, but we'll see. I always clean my stuff with WD-40 anyway, so this is a nice shiny thing, nice and nice quality. This clamp. So it's nothing to install one of these on the bike, it's two bolts. That's a bit, I'll have to come over that way. Probably just be bang on. Bring this down a bit. I'll give it a good clean with Windoline. I think the Windoline's in the kitchen. I'll give it a good clean with Windoline so I've got no fingerprints all over it. I don't want fingerprint burn marks on my exhaust. Brand new exhaust. That kind of box that a little bit. Let's push that up. Push this down. Just getting this strap together and getting it on right. Doing it right. Do it the right way. Take your time. It's not a race. I might need to cut a bit. I just need to cut that just a tiny little bit. But I'll do that after. I'll determine what it's like first. But that might need a wee cut. Look, that'll be fine. That'll be great. Seems to be symmetrical, so I could put that back. Brilliant. Right, so put the stuff in my pocket. I might get these tacked on. I'll speak to the local garage. And I might as well use this new bolt as well. Stainless, so why not? Yeah, is that a 13? If I get the tools I need. And I'll get this back to you when I've got that on the bike. So it's exactly the same. It's a 13 back nut and then it's a 14 at the front. Yeah, I might go and get them welded. Let's see. See if I've got time today. Change of cost. Just two little tacks, innit? I'll keep that washer actually, or the best washer I've got. Don't need this nut anymore. What's the better washer? When's that one's going to the back? It don't matter. Get the sands off. See, that's make sure my hands are clean. Put this all over. Yep, just slip straight over it. Kind of different colour, it's more satin, isn't it? Not shiny. But it don't matter. I ain't bothered. Is this strap going to be alright? We need to go on the inside. I think it needs to go on the outside. Might have to use the other strap. I can't use the other strap because it needs to go on the inside. I'll turn it a little bit there, turn the pipe. Get the bolt ready. That bolt ain't bolty enough, but I'll use the bits and pieces. Do this. Keep that strap in place. What's happening here then? Does this link plate need to turn? Because the link plate is bolted, you see. If I turn the silencer, I think the link plate will need to turn. I might have to loosen that off a bit. Put this in. Ah, because that's not a lock nut. So it uses a spring washer. Okay. Yeah, it's sitting right on that. So I've got a feeling I have to take that off. And I need a 13mm socket to do that. Just use this. Just loosen it, see if it's loosening it, does it? Is it 13 or 14 that? I think it's 13. Yeah, it's a 13. Just loosen it a little bit. I'm going to go and get a socket. So that's it there, find the cloth. And a bit of this stuff. Make sure the cloth's nice and clean. Get all the fingerprints off it. Give it half a chance. It's going to get dirty in 5 seconds, but anyway. I've got a feeling I'm going to have to take the baffles out of this thing, the DB killer, because it's a very small silencer. So I think it'll restrict this bandit. But we shall see. Not too worried about that bit, but I'll just want the fingerprints off all this. Okay. Start up. it's not leaking there, but you can feel it, hear it leaking when you tighten this up, tighten this thing up. Sounds nice. Taking this down a bit.